Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use something that I use extensively, and that's coupons and vouchers. Actually, I don't use coupons, but I use vouchers, but I'm going to show you both. So let's jump into the back end of the website. Now, we're going to find those options right here under orders. So this is actually where we're going to see all our orders that get placed. But right here is coupons and here is vouchers. And they're a little different, but they can essentially do some of the same things. So first I'll click on coupons. So you can generate a coupon code really easy for any of your courses or your membership. And there's lots of flexibility here with it. I personally am not a believer in issuing coupons, but I know there are situations where coupons are helpful to issue. I just don't like the idea of discounting something that you create. And I don't like the sense that it gives people that everyone's paying a different price. I personally don't like that feeling myself, so I don't want to give that to my students, but I'm going to show you coupons. Vouchers is different, and vouchers is pretty darn sweet. So here you can choose the type of discount, whether it's a dollar discount or a percentage. So if you're applying the coupon to different courses that are priced differently, you might want to go the percentage route, but it's completely up to you. Then right here, we can choose the type of access plans that it applies to. Let me explain this in perfect English. If you have one-time payment courses, then that is one type of access plan. If you have courses that are monthly reoccurring or annual reoccurring, that's a different type of access plan. So you can have it be just on those one-time ones or the reoccurring ones. So you can choose which one you want it to apply to or both. It's super easy. And so I'm assuming right here for the amount, if you chose the dollar amount, you'd put the dollar amount in, or if you chose the percentage right here, you would pop in a percentage. I don't use coupons personally. So anyways, enable trial pricing discount. So this is if you wanted to discount the trial price, you can turn this on and you kind of have similar options right there. Here are the restrictions, and these are going to be the courses that you are allowing this coupon to be applied to and the memberships. So you can choose more than one course, more than one membership, whatever you want. And you can pop in an expiration date and also a usage limit. And that's kind of a scarcity thing. So if you're given a webinar and you're saying, here's a limited discount, it's only available for the next 20 people who purchase, you can do that if you wanted this way by limiting the usage. And that would actually be a good idea. And that's kind of sometimes where it's appropriate to offer a discount, is if you're doing it in a webinar or some kind of special thing along those lines. And then you can pop in a description. This is for more of an internal purpose than anything. But that is coupons. I don't use coupons, but you do have that ability to use them. Heck, maybe that might change in the future. But what I do like is vouchers. And so a voucher is different. Actually, hold on. I screwed up. Let me tell you where you can enter the coupon. And here's how there's some difference. So if I click on here to go to my checkout, right here is where someone enters a coupon. Vouchers, you don't actually enter a voucher here. Voucher doesn't get someone a discount, it gets someone access. So people can buy vouchers offline. So say you're giving a in-person seminar and you're selling access to some of your materials, you can sell them a voucher code if you wanted, or something along those lines. Or if you had some system where you didn't want LifterLMS to be the one accepting the money, you can have any other way of accepting money and then give people a voucher code. So this is where you do a coupon. Vouchers are different. You would go to, or whoever had a voucher code would go to the members dashboard, click on a redeem a voucher, and enter in that voucher code right there. Now let me explain what the heck these vouchers are to begin with. So I'm going to click on add a voucher, and it's very powerful, okay? So you could have a voucher code give someone access to multiple courses. So if you wanted a course bundle, you could do it that way, or a membership or multiple memberships, whatever you want. And you can generate as many of these voucher codes as you want. So here's a perfect example. Say I wanted to give someone access to this course right here via a voucher. So I would go there, I would go ahead and pop my course in, and right here I would say, generate 20 new voucher codes right here. I would say each voucher code is good towards one redemption. So that means as soon as someone uses a voucher code, that voucher code can't be used anymore. If I wanted it to be two, so someone could use it twice, I don't see a reason to do that. For me, in my mind, it would always be to use once. Or maybe if a company purchased 10 user licenses or whatever, or 10 seats or 10 enrollments into a course, maybe that's another use for a voucher, I would think, where they would say give you a fixed fee for 10 enrollments and you can facilitate that via the voucher system. So you could have a voucher code be good towards 10 enrollments. So I'm going to do one, and that's typically how I do it, but maybe that's the scenario that you would want. And you can see here's all your generated codes, and it's just a random code. And then right here under uses, you can see how many times it's been used. Obviously, none of these have been used yet. And then you would just go ahead and publish it. So actually, let me do this real quick. Okay, I just gave it a title. You would probably want to have it be a more descriptive name than that. I'm going to click on publish, and then I'll show you the redemptions and all that kind of stuff. Obviously, no one's redeemed any because I haven't given any of these stinking vouchers out yet. So if I click on redemptions, this will give you a list of which student redeemed which code, which is kind of cool. And you can actually click on this right here and you can download a CSV of those voucher codes, or here to download a list of the redeemed ones, or right here to have this information be emailed. They actually just fixed this. This wasn't working, but now it's supposed to be. But the vouchers right here, just download a CSV and pop it into Excel. That's what I do. So anyways, let's take one of these codes. I wonder if I can use it, even though I'm already enrolled in this course. Let's see what happens. So let me see. If I click on dashboard, actually, I'm not enrolled in it. I'm only enrolled in that quick free course I made. So I'm going to click on redeem a voucher. And this is what you'll tell your customer to do. To create an account, click on redeem a voucher, enter the code right there, and click on submit. And it went ahead and redeemed it. So if I go back to dashboard, you can see now I'm enrolled in that course. And it was that simple. So if I go here, and probably if I do a refresh, we're going to see this change. So you can see now this code was used. And if I go to redemptions, you could see it was used right there. And you can actually change things. You can change the code. You can increase this number. So if I wanted to add another redemption on that, I could. And then click on update. It's really powerful and really easy to use. I really love this voucher system. I think it really opens this learning platform up to all kinds of creative ways of bundling and selling your courses and your memberships through it. So this is the coupons and the vouchers. Oh, hey, let me just tell you, if you have someone with their voucher code and they try to use that voucher code as a coupon when they are checking out, it's not going to work. So make sure they know. I mean, it clearly says redeem a voucher. And when you're, say, here going to buy a course, I think I have actually purchased all of these courses. So let me try to purchase the membership right here. So if I go to the membership and take it here, someone puts a voucher code right here, it's not going to work. This will only work for coupons. So I know that has caused some confusion for some of the people on my website that are just, you got to assume that people aren't going to read the information you give them. And it's hard, but a lot of times people are moving so quick that they think this is where I put the voucher code, but it clearly says coupon code, but they're not thinking it's not the same thing. So you might, if you're going to use coupons and vouchers, you might have some people doing some screwy things. You'll just have to figure out how to overcome those as they do it. Anyways, that's my insider tip from someone that actually uses this system. Thanks for watching.